Question number 33. Examine that sine of mod x is a continuous function. Sine of mod x. Now, will you start for sine? Suppose we will take the question as f of x. Sine of mod x. Now, we have to take two functions, h and g, so that one of the composition will give you the function f. Okay. Suppose we are taking h of x and g of x. H of x as sine x and g of x as mod x. Now, we have to see which will give you your f of x, that is sine of mod x. Okay. So, first we will start with h composition g of x, which is h of g of x. Is h of, what is g of x? It is mod x. Now, if it is h of x, you will get sine of x. When it is h of mod x, what you will get your function to be? Sine of whatever is the angle. Right? यहाँ पे जो x है उसके place में जो आपने डाला है that you should get as the sine's angle. So you'll get sine of mod x and this is the required one. So you can say that h composition g is your f and it is defined. Now you have to show that f is continuous. For that what we will do, we'll show that h of x and g of x both are continuous so that their composition is continuous. Okay? We'll start with h of x. H of x equal to sine x. How to show that it is continuous? Let's see, belongs to R. Then you have to take f of c, which is sine c. Again, you have to take limit. For limit x tends to c f of x, you have to replace your x with suppose c plus h. So that as your x tends to c, your h will tends to 0. So this is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of c plus h. If f of x is sine x, what is f of c plus h? It is sine of c plus h. Now expand it, limit h tends to 0, sin a cos b. So you get sin c cos h plus cos c sin h equal to, again you are replacing the limit, that is sin c will come out, limit h tends to 0 cos h plus cos c will come out, limit h tends to 0 sin h. This limit will give you cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. So you'll get sin c into 1 plus cos c into, here you have sin 0. Sin 0 is cos c into 0. It's sin c. Limit extends to c, f of x is sin c and f of c is also sin c. Therefore, what? Limit extends to c, f of x is equal to f of c. That is, f is continuous. It is a continuous function, you can see. The f nahi, yahan pe kya hai f? Oh, bar bar f is h, okay? H. Here also you have h of x equal to h of c. So, h is a continuous function. Here, now you have to show that this mod of x, that is, you have taken as g of mod x, that is continuous. G of x is equal to mod x is continuous, you have to show. For that, what we will start with? LC belongs to R. Here, actually, you have to check for different cases. Why? Because mod x is x and minus x as your x is greater than or equal to 0 and x is less than 0. So you have to check for the case where c is greater than 0, c is less than 0 and c is equal to 0. We'll just make it as case 1, 2, 3. Case 1 will give you, suppose c is less than 0. A real number which is less than 0. So you have to check for f of c, which is equal to, since it is less than 0, you have to take minus c. Now limit x tends to c, f of x will give you limit x tends to c. Again, you have to replace your f of x with the function related to x less than 0. Any number less than 0 is negative of that number. So here you are again getting minus c. And so you can say that f of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x. That is, function is continuous for all the elements which are less than 0. Okay. Now case 2 is when you have c is greater than 0. And c is greater than 0, your f of c will become what? Greater than 0, c. And limit x tends to c, f of x will be limit x tends to c. Again, instead of f of x, you have to replace it with x because it is greater than 0. X, which is equal to, therefore f of c is equal to limit x tends to c f of x. And so you can say that the function is d. So g is continuous for all x which are greater than 0. Okay. The third case is when c is equal to 0. When c is equal to 0, you have to check at the point less than 0 and greater than 0. You have g of c as when c is 0, same function you will get. That is, it is what you will get? 0 itself. Because c ko 0 liya hai, g of c ka matlab g of 0 hai. So it is 0. Okay. Now what you have? G of 0 will accept. Okay. G of 0 is equal to 0. You don't have any doubt. Now you have to check for left limit. That is, limit x tends to 0 minus d of x equal to limit x tends to 0. What is the function taken as when it is less than 0? 0 minus means it is less than 0. Less than 0 ke liye minus x log. And now you have to replace this x value with 0. So you get minus 0, which is again 0. Now right hand limit. Limit x tends to 0. You use x. Again 0. So all the three coinciding, that is LHL equal to RHL equal to at the point G of 0. And so you can say that G is continuous for X equal to 0 also. So for greater than 0, for less than 0, and for equal to 0, for all the three cases the function is continuous. Therefore, g is a continuous function. Yahan tak aana chahiye, continuous function tak milega in general. Tabhi aap do continuous function ke composition ko continuous bol sakte ho. Itna karna padega when this is asked. When mod of sine of mod x is a continuous function, you have to show, you have whatever you have to take, you have to split it into two functions, take the composition, and separately you have to show that they are continuous functions. When they are continuous functions, you'll get the composition to be continuous function. So at last what you need to write, therefore, since you have h and g both are continuous functions, since h of x equal to sine x and g of x equal to mod x are both continuous functions, comma, f which is equal to, which composition you got as f? H composition. F is equal to h composition g is also a continuous function. Okay. Understood? Next one is 34. Find all the points of discontinuity of f defined by f of x is equal to mod x minus mod of x plus 1. Again, here you have two functions, mod x and mod of x plus 1. Both are modulus functions. Actually, if it is for one mark, you can just say that both are continuous. Modulus functions are continuous. आपको जो देखना है वो है फाइंड ऑल पॉइंट्स ऑफ डिसकंटिन्यूटी सो वी नीड टू चेक सेपरेटली एंड देन से दैट वेदर दे आर हैविंग एनी डिसकंटिन्यूटी और नॉट ओके द मेन थिंग वेयर यू नीड टू चेक इज दिस फंक्शन शुड बी चेक्ड एट x इक्वल टू 0 बिकॉज़ एट दैट पॉइंट द फंक्शन सी मॉड x का जो ग्राफ है सपोज दिस इज h ऑफ x द ग्राफ ऑफ मॉड x इज लाइक दिस सो इट इज हैविंग अ चेंज एट द पॉइंट 0 Here you have x, here you have minus x. Okay, so इसका जब zero का neighborhood होगा, तो वहाँ पे दो functions, दो values देंगे. That's why we are checking for this. Now, what about this function? If this is your g of x, your graph will be a V shape, but where it will touch, वो कैसे find out करते हैं बताती हूँ. X plus one जो inside term है, उसको equate to zero. You get x is equal to minus one. That means the point where
हमारा zero.
Yeah.
माइनस वन कॉमा जीरो पे
माइनस वन पे यहाँ पे टच करेगा माइनस वन कॉमा जीरो पे होगा वो वी शेप जहाँ टच होगा ओके ऐसे आएगा सो एवरी टाइम मॉडुलस विल गिव यू अ वी शेप बट वेयर इट हैव इट इज टचिंग द एक्स एक्सिस दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज द फंक्शन गिवन इनसाइड द मॉडुलस ओके सो हियर इट विल टच एट माइनस वन नाउ सपोज द क्वेश्चन वॉज मॉड ऑफ एक्स माइनस वन देन वेयर इट विल टच एट एक्स इक्वल टू वन हियर ऐसे होगा वी शेप ठीक है मच यू अंडरस्टूड So, आपका जो मेन पॉइंट है जहां आप चेक करते हो वो ये है इसमें भी जैसे यहाँ जीरो है यहाँ पे माइनस वन पे होगा जो फंक्शन चेंज कर रहा है हियर यू विल गेट माइनस ऑफ एक्स प्लस वन एंड हियर इट विल बी एक्स प्लस वन द फंक्शन ठीक है सो वी नीड टू चेक फॉर बोथ सेपरेटली देन ऑलरेडी वी हैव अ थ्योरम दैट इफ दिस फंक्शन एंड दिस फंक्शन बोथ आर कंटिन्यूअस देन देयर डिफरेंस इज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूअस अंडरस्टूड So we'll take let h of x. Here you need not take any composition because you have a separation here as negative sign in between. You can take these two as separate two functions. H of x is let h of x is mod x, and g of x is mod of x plus one. So h of x mod x के लिए हम क्या करते हैं? For this function, when you are checking or you are showing that you have any point of discontinuity or not, you have to separate it as three cases. Case one. Let c be any number which is less than zero. Now, why we are यहाँ से क्यों चेंज कर रहे हैं तीन क्योंकि यहाँ का फंक्शन चेंज x less than or equal to zero greater than or equal to zero इसमें होगा ठीक है इसको मैं पहले सिर्फ h of x ले रही हूँ so that I can just separate it as x minus x x greater than or equal to zero x less than zero. What we have done earlier that is let c is less than zero so we get f of c is same as और क्या मिलेगा लेस देन जीरो में माइनस सी एंड लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू सी एफ ऑफ एक्स विल गिव यू लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू सी एफ ऑफ एक्स यू विल रिप्लेस इट विद माइनस एक्स माइनस सी देयरफॉर एफ ऑफ सी इक्वल टू लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू सी एक्स दैट इज एक्स Therefore, h is continuous for all those values which are less than zero. Now, case two. Let c be equal to zero. Now, for equal to zero, you have to check at the point f of zero, which is again zero. Left limit zero minus f of x, which is limit x tends to zero. F of x is what? Instead of x, you have to replace it with. So you get zero here. Again, you have limit x tends to zero plus f of x is equal to limit x tends to zero. Well, this is your minus x since it is left. Now for right, it is x. It's again giving you zero. Therefore, f of zero is equal to limit x tends to zero minus f of x is equal to limit x tends to zero plus f of x. That that is f is continuous for x equal to 0. Case 3 is when c is greater than 0. Now when c is greater than 0, you have f of c to be x. Here you will get now to be f will be given h. Whatever you have taken as the function, you replace it with that. H of c will be what? And it is greater than 0, you will have c. Here you have minus c, here you will have c. Now for limit extends to c, h of x will give you limit extends to c. Kya aega? Will again give you c. So for both the cases you have means, therefore the function is continuous. H is continuous for all x greater than 0. So for all the three cases you have proved means there is no other point where you can find out the discontinuity. So this function is continuous everywhere. That means you can say that yahan pe aap conclusion case likhoge, is function ke liye discontinuity kahin pe bhi nahi hai. Therefore h of x equal to mod x does not have any point of discontinuity. Discontinuous everywhere because it is continuous for less than 0, equal to 0 and greater than 0 all the values. Okay, so this is the conclusion made here in this question. Now we will go for the second part, which is g of x. So isse thoda alag hai because point wahan pe change hoga, yahan 0 tha usme accordingly change karenge, that will see. Okay, this is clear. So remember that h of x, we have proved that it doesn't have any discontinuity. Now we are going for g of x, which has been taken as mod of x plus 1. Now when g of x is mod of x plus 1, you have to separate it into two cases. By definition, what is it? Either it will be positive or it will be negative as your term you have taken. Mod of x is greater than or equal to 0 or it is less than 0. Now when I write like this, I can modify this term. Isko fir se main alag kar sakti hu kaise? Iski ko main aise likh sakti hu x plus 1 and minus of x plus 1 as your x is greater than or equal to minus 1. That means x ke hisab se likhna hai humko. So this positive one going there will become negative one. So you can say that when x, it will give you x plus 1 when your x is greater than or equal to minus 1 and negative of x plus 1 when your x is less than minus. Okay, वहाँ पे जो zero से लिखा था यहाँ पे उसको ऐसे replace करना. ये वही definition है जैसे हम mod x का लिखते थे. Mod x का क्या लिखते थे? It will come as x or minus x. So instead of x, what you have written. और वो x greater than equal to zero or less than zero में define करते थे. Here we have just taken this part as the other. ये उस तरफ right hand side में लेकर गए. तो it is greater than equal to minus one and less than minus one. Now we will separate cases into three. What will be the cases? You can take your c as greater than minus 1, less than minus 1 and at the point minus 1. All the three you have to check. Okay, so first case is suppose c is any number which is less than minus 1. Understood? In mod x you have checked for 0, less than 0, greater than 0 and at x equal to 0. Yahan pe less than minus 1, greater than minus 1 and at the point minus 1 we will check. Okay, what will be f of c when it is less than minus 1? Baki same hoga. Dekho definition yahan pe dekho, x is less than minus 1 means you have your function to be minus of. So you get minus of and you replace your x with c. So you get minus of c plus 1. Correct? Okay. Now limit extends to c, f of x will be limit extends to c. Again you will replace your f of x with the same function, that is minus of x plus 1, and replace your x with c. So you get minus of c plus 1. So both the values are same. That means you can say that f of x limit extends to c f of x is same as f of c. That is the function f g. function g is continuous for all those values. Are less than minus 1. Okay, now second case is let c be any number which is greater than minus 1 because both are of same type, because function change karega yahan pe. G of c will be what? Greater than minus 1 hai to kaun sa function lena hai aapko? X plus 1. So here you will have c plus 1 replacing your x with c. Now limit extends to c, g of x will be limit extends to c. What is g of x? Again, it is x plus 1. So you'll have here x plus 1 and replace this x with c. So that you'll get c plus 1. Therefore, g of c is same as limit extends to c g of x. That is, g is continuous for all those values which are greater than minus 1. So two cases completed. Now the third case is at the point c equal to minus 1 we have. Okay. Is 3 when your c is minus 1. So you will check for f of minus 1 because your c is minus 1. You can write g of minus 1. G of minus 1 means again you have to take this function and replace your x with minus 1. Understood? Replace your x with minus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 is 0. Understood? अब हम c से replace करते हैं. यहाँ पे देखो c से replace किया. उस c की जगह आप डालोगे क्या? माइनस वन. ओके, सी की जगह यहाँ माइनस वन लेना है. सो जी ऑफ माइनस वन का मतलब है जो फंक्शन एप्लीकेबल है उस फंक्शन में एक्स को माइनस वन से रिप्लेस किया और जहां पे इक्वल टू है वही फंक्शन लेना है यहाँ पे जी ऑफ. ठीक है. नाउ लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट व्हिच इज लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू माइनस वन माइनस. ओके, ये नोटेशन देखना. माइनस वन इज द नंबर टू विच इट इज गोइंग फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट साइड, देयरफॉर इट इज नेगेटिव. अपर पार्ट में माइनस डालना है. G of x will be limit extends to minus 1. Which value you have to replace? Left side means less than minus 1. So you have to replace with this value, which is minus of x plus 1. Okay. Now what you need to do? You have to replace your x with minus 1. So minus of minus 1 plus 1. Since it is becoming 0, aapka value change nahi karega. Yahan pe fir se wo 0 hi dega. Limit extends to 1 minus 1 plus. Minus 1 plus ka matlab kya hai? It is approaching to minus 1 from the right side of minus 1. That is what this means. And this is g of x. Limit extends to minus 1. Which function? Again, plus. Minus 1 plus means it is from the right side. It is greater than minus 1. Greater than minus 1 means x plus 1. X plus 1. Again, replace your x value with minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. All the three you are getting to be 0. Therefore, g of minus 1 is same as limit extends to minus 1 minus g of x is equal to limit extends to minus 1 plus g of x. That is, g is continuous at x equal to minus 1. So, less than minus 1, greater than minus 1, and at x equal to minus 1, the function is continuous. Hence, you can say that the function g, that is g of x is equal to mod of x plus 1, is or doesn't have any point of discontinuity. Now, since you got that h of x as well as g of x both doesn't have any point of discontinuity, the function f of x, function f of x, which is your h minus g, okay, f is also not having any point of discontinuity, or you can say that there is no point of discontinuity for the function f of x. Okay. Is it clear?